Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in a Cube. And you ever configure incremental refresh and then you realize it failed on a few days and then it starts succeeding and you're concerned, did it pick up that data? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly what happens. Stay tuned. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. You set up incremental refresh, you're doing daily refreshes of your data set. Maybe you're out on vacation or something and a couple of days fail and then you got back and it succeeded and you're like, well, what happened under the covers? Did it pick those up? And you go take a look and you see it created those partitions. Oh, how do you do that? How can I test this to make sure it's working? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. So you know how we like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I've created a data set and I've configured incremental refresh. You'll see right here, archive a year and refresh the current day. Pretty simple. And then I published it out to the service and normally I'll do a scheduled refresh there, but I wanna simulate some things. The first thing I wanna do is I check my data set and the latest date in my data set is June the 4th. So I want to go back in time a little bit. I want to pretend like today's date is June the 10th. Then I'll skip up to June the 14th. Let me show you how I do this. You can connect to the XMLA endpoint and you can write a little XMLA and one of the properties you can specify is the effective date. It'll pretend like today's date is June the 10th. So when I do my incremental refresh, it's going to refresh up until today. So if I run this, it's gonna go and do a full refresh of my model because this is the initial refresh of it. So it's gonna go and get all the data, populate that year, bring me up until June the 10th, which is my effective date. So once it finishes, we're gonna go over and find this model. The name of the model is IR, incremental refresh with effective date. I'm gonna right click on it. I'm gonna go to partitions. What you're gonna see is a full year because I said archive a year and then refresh the date up until today. Because I set that effective date, instead of using the actual date of today, it's just going up to June 10th. So today is like January 1st, 2023. So now imagine you've been away, June the 11th comes around, the refresh fails. June 12th, it fails. June 13th, it fails. And then it starts succeeding on June 14th. What actually happens under the covers? Let me show you. The maximum date in my source table is June the 14th. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change this to June 14th. So the refresh failed for all the days between the 10th and the 14th. I'm gonna go ahead and run this, and this should be really quick because it's only gonna refresh the current day. At least that's what you think it's doing. So now we go here and we go back to that data set and we right click on that table and we go to partitions, and lo and behold, guess what happens? It succeeded on this day, it failed on these 3 days, and it succeeded here. But incremental refresh is so smart, it's so self-healing that it actually went back and created the partitions and populated those partitions for the days that it failed. And I did test this for months and quarters. I didn't test it for years, but it behaves the exact same way. If you miss a quarter, it creates that quarter and populates that quarter. Same thing for months. What do you think? You got any questions? You got any comments? Were you worried that incremental refresh wasn't taking care of business? Well, don't be. If you have any questions, you have any comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.